This lesson is about pulse reflection from fixed and free ends. Learning objectives. Compare and contrast a single pulse reflection from a fixed and loose ends. Use animation to explain the shape of a reflected pulse at the boundary. Identify interferences between two pulses traveling in the same medium. And practice pulse interference using PHET wave on a string virtual lab. Let us consider what happens to a pulse when it reaches the end of a median. The median can be fixed, like a rope tied to a wall, or it can be free, like a rope tied loosely to a pole. When the end of the median is fixed, this pulse will reflect from the free end inverted. When the end of the median is free, this pulse will reflect from the free end but not inverted. The fixed and free ends are examples of boundary conditions. The shape of a reflected pulse for a fixed end and for a free end of boundary conditions is affected by two undetected pulses. The unreflected pulse that propagates through the median and the undisturbed pulse, these and these. I will explain this using this online simulation with animation. The idea about this animation is to observe the behavior of a pulse when it hits a boundary for two situations, a free end and a fixed end. I will explain the results of this animation in terms of wave interference. A pulse is half of a wave. Sometimes it's useful to use a pulse instead of a complete wave to observe wave's properties to keep sample. Let me explain parts of this animation in practical ways for a better understanding. This pink line is a string with one end attached to a boundary through two ways. One is a fixed end and the other one is a free end, like the string attached to a ring around a pole and free to move. Let me start by selecting the fixed end and run this animation. This is the incident pulse moving to the right, and this is the reflected pulse moving to the left. We notice the reflected pulse restore its shapes after hits the boundary and bounce back to the median with the same shape and with the same speed, but inverted. To understand this behavior, let's select the box to show the unreflected incident pulse, and as you notice, this pulse is being transmitted to the median. Now let's check the box, show undisturbed reflected pulse, this blue one. It shows the unreflected pulse, the blue, overlapping with the transmitted pulse, which is the red, as they meet the boundary. During this overlapping, destructive interference occurs. Then, as both pulses move away, the reflected pulse is restored and returns to the median inverted. Now, let's uncheck all these boxes. select the free end, reset this animation, and run one more time. We observe the incident pulse amplitude double as it hits the boundary, then restore to its original amplitude and return to the median. To understand this behavior, let's again select the box to show unreflected incident pulse. We notice the wave is being transmitted to the median. Now let me check the box show undisturbed reflected pulse. It shows the blue pulse overlapping with the red pulse. Both waves are overlapping here at the boundary. Here occurs constructive interference. As a result, the incident pulse amplitude is double. And as the blue and red pulses move away, the amplitude is restored to its original shape as the pulse returns to the median. In conclusion, for the fixed end, at the boundary, destructive interference occurs and the reflected pulse restores its original size as it returns to the median inverted. For the free end, constructor interference occurs at the boundary and the reflected pulse restores to its normal amplitude at return to the median. Now, when two pulses pass through the same median at the same time, they interact. The resulting pulse is obtained by using constructive interference or destructive interference. This shoe is also called superposition. After pulses pass through each other, each pulse continues along its original direction of travel, and the original amplitudes remain unchanged. The next video, I will do a practice pulse interference using PHET Wave on a String Virtual Lab. This wave on a string simulation, we are using fixed and loose ends to observe constructive and destructive interference between two pulses traveling through the same median, in this case, a string. To conduct this practice, select pulse. For amplitude, slide up to 1.25. For pulse width, select 0.25 seconds. Non-damping, high tension. These settings provide a better view of this interaction. First, let's observe the behavior of a single pulse traveling through this string. Notice this end is fixed at the pulse generator, and at this end, I can select fixed or loose end. Click on this green button and create a pulse. Let's run with a normal speed. Now let's select slow motion. Let's stop and use the time frame to observe with more detail how the pulse is traveling. This is great to view interference with more details. Click on Restart and select Loose End. Create a pulse and let's observe in slow motion. So watch the video post in this lesson, post reflection, free and fixed ends, to understand the shape of these reflected pulse. So let's click on restart. Now let's select fix end and create two consecutive pulses and observe in slow motion its interference. One, two. So we notice sections of destructive interference. So for a closer look, let's use the time frame to observe the sequence how it occurs. Let's select a timer. And let's record the time it takes for 5 destructive interference occurs in this case. One, two, three, four, five. So about 5.67 seconds takes for 5 destructive interference occurs. So now let's restart and select loose end. Reset the timer and create 2 pulses and observe its interference. One, two. So we can observe destructive and constructive interference. This is constructive interference, destructive interference here, and constructive interference. So we have positive constructive interference on the positive side, negative constructive interference, and we have destructive interference. So we can, to make it simple, we can count the time it takes for 5 interference occurs. One, two, three, four, five. In conclusion, you can use this animation to create 2 pulses for one of those 2 situations, fix or loose ends, and observe wave interference, constructive and destructive interference.